All right, everybody, super excited to present to everyone today. We'll get started here in maybe about 2 or 3 minutes. We had a huge crowd signed up for today, so I want to get everybody to get a chance their audio up and going. So if you could in the chat box, we're going to keep everybody muted for the presentation, but if you could in the chat box, tell me what city you are calling from. I know we have people signed up from all across the country, which is super cool. So tell me what city that you're calling from in the chat box, and we'll get started here in about 2 minutes. Okay, everybody? And in the meantime, I'm going to play a little rock music to set the mood and get us up and going, guys.
Gosh, I hope it's Eye of the Tiger.
I'm a John Cougar Mellencamp guy, so that's what we're going with.
Let's go. You have to have a hype man. Hello, everybody. Hi, John Thompson from Wake of the Ozarks. I know you. I mean, I know most of you guys. When I was a young boy, Chase Dunkelberger, what's up, my dude? Nice to see you. Boy, hello. Ryan, hello. What's up? I think my guys all know Altimoto because you're all so cool. And I love having you. In the same best word. It's the very fun. Jim, hello. Christopher. Hello. It's now taking the fun. I'm so bad.
All right, guys. Hey, we'll get started here in about 1 more minute, everyone. So again, tell me where you're calling from. We have people signed up from all across the country on this. I see Oklahoma, Georgia, Illinois. It is just crazy. So super excited. Tell me what your go-to song is, guys. So I grew up in the 80s, early 90s with two older sisters. So we listened to a lot of John Cougar Mellencamp back in the day. But tell me what your go-to song is here as well. I say play Freebird, Justin. Mm-hmm. I love it. So tell me, and we'll get started here in about 40 more seconds. Okay, guys?
Yeah, we still got people hopping on.
Yeah, so just give me a chance. So about 45 more seconds. Okay, guys?
I personally like to go real heavy with the bass to get ramped up. Bass nectar is my shit.
Everybody, so Beck, the reason I play that song specifically is if you listen to the words, you know, it says it hurts so good. And we're going to talk a lot about lead generation and prospecting. And so when it's all said and done, guys, it might hurt while you're doing it, but man, it feels good when you get the ROI and the leads that you're generating and the transactions that you're getting. It feels so good. So super excited to be on today, Becca. I appreciate you having me.
Absolutely, guys. I'm super stoked. Tyler is just a ball of positive energy, and we love Cole Information Systems. And so I'm going to introduce Tyler here today. But this is Tyler Stenkin, and he's been with Cole Information for 16 years as the Director of Strategic Partnerships. And he works with almost 100 coaches in the insurance and real estate space all across the country. And I'm super jazzed. I've actually been recommending to people Cole Information for the past couple of years. I've gotten to see the system through a couple of people. Greg Ellsbury has been in contact with me several times over the last couple of years. But when people ask me questions, like especially about commercial leads, or if they're trying to, you know, get lead sources without knocking doors, it's like, how do you get to the gatekeeper? How do you find the owner of the property? And I always say, check out Cole Information. And yes. So we're Tyler's going to really show us like a deep dive into what the system is, how it works, how it can work for you guys. And I think this is going to be the answer to a lot of your questions about lead generation outside of, you know, door knocking and stuff like that. So Tyler, take it away. I'm going to be interjecting just a little commentary and let you guys know how I feel that can help you in your businesses, but let's dive in.
Awesome. Awesome. And true story, guys, is, you know, how I heard of Becca was about, I don't know, 2 or 3 weeks ago. I always ask our inside sales team, how did you hear about us? What brought you, you know, why do you call us? And your name kept on getting brought up, right? And so I pinged you on Facebook and emailed you and said, hey, let's talk. Well, number one, thanks for the referrals, right? We love referrals. But number two is, what can we do to support you? And this is why we're on a webinar today, right? And so it's always so good to hear of third-party sources recommending our services, right? And our product itself, we've been around for 70 years, everybody. 7 decades we've been in this business. And so me, over the last 16 years, I support all of these different partnerships across the country. So whether it's in the real estate side of things and, you know, real estate coaches are pushing our product, or in our neighborhood product for roofers and plumbers and things like that. And I'll tell you what, recently, Becca, is we have had a huge uptick of small businesses reaching out to us saying, hey, we need help. We need help prospecting. We can't door knock right now, you know, right. And we were buying hot leads maybe from sources, and those have kind of dried up. And so the reason why a lot of these major coaching companies are referring a ton of business to us even more is that they are telling their customers to double down on lead generation, double down on your outreach, right? You can't be left behind, and things are going to eventually open up again. And you got to make sure that you're putting yourself in the best position to succeed. Is that what you're kind of hearing as well, and what you're kind of teaching, Becca?
Well, I mean, especially right now with the COVID stuff, it's like, how can you, people are emailing me all the time about, but do you have telemarketing scripts? How can we get leads? Mm-hmm. How can we figure out who owns these properties? And so I definitely think with the environment that we're working in right now, it's kind of forced people to think outside the box and really adapt their sales process. And so that's why I feel like, you know, getting this laser sharp, find the owner, find their name, their contact information, yep, and the way that you can use Cole Systems to do so, I feel like that's really going to be a giant tool in the arsenal for these guys. So
absolutely. So if you don't mind, I have a little PowerPoint presentation that I might just throw up right now. And so we can kind of, you know, talk some off some bullet points there as well. And then a little session framework, everybody, I'm going to keep everybody muted. I've done enough of these webinars over the years. Once you start unmuting people, there's background noise. People don't realize they don't have a speaker on their computer. It's just better off. So we are going to be monitoring the question, the chat box throughout. We'll probably just wait, though, to address a lot of those questions at the very end, because we'll probably cover a lot of the questions that you have during the presentation as well. And then we'll stay on as long as we need to answer any questions you guys might have. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen here. And then if you don't mind, can you tell me if you actually see my screen? I've had it before too, where people are like halfway through it, Tyler, we don't see your screen. You see it right now? Okay, perfect. So we should be good to go. So like I said, we've been around for 70 years, Becca. So 7 decades, right? So prior to technology, prior to the internet, we were known for printing these crisscross books. And the only reason I like to say that is there might be people on the call today who are like, oh yeah, I remember those. I remember when I first started out in the business that I'm in, my sales manager gave me one of these directories to call out of. And so if you're not familiar with them, essentially they're like a phone book, but instead of by last name, they were by street name. So I could open up one of these directories, let's say for Lincoln, Nebraska, where I live, it would have all the streets in that city in alphabetical order. I open up and find Patterson Street, and would tell me everybody who lives on Patterson Street by house number, 505, 506, 507, tell me who lives there, their phone number, what their home value is, just different things like that. So any small business would use it as a way to network with neighbors, you know a person's name before you door knocked. Even police departments use this. So I remember 15 years ago, Law and Order, the TV series, actually called us up and asked us to send a directory out to their set because they wanted to have one of the detectives on screen say, hey, go up, grab the Cole directory and call everybody in the apartment building to see if they saw the break-in that happened, right? So fast forward, we're at where we're at now, and we'll jump into that in a bit, but we provide neighborhood contact information where you can search by a zip code, a neighborhood, or a street, and get everybody who lives there, their cell phone number, their email addresses, and lots of different demographics about them as well. And it's not just used in roofing and plumbing and contractors, you know, it's all industries when it's all said and done. So I challenge everybody today, before we get started, to think about what your goals are for 2020. And I get with COVID-19, it's changed things, right? And so you might have to make adjustments to your goals. But what are your goals and what are you gonna do to make it happen? Because I'm hopeful that your goals are still higher than on what you did last year. And if, in order to match those goals, you need to be adding new things, new strategies to your marketing, to your prospecting, to your outreach. So what we're gonna talk about today are three strategies that everyone can do immediately. We're gonna talk about how to dominate a neighborhood, right? Where's your ideal neighborhood and how do you wanna go after them, right? We're gonna talk about how to leverage technology to help make it happen for you guys as well. And we're also gonna talk about micro marketing. So basically I want you guys to sit back and decide who's your ideal prospect and how do you plan on going after them as well. And again, Cole, what we allow you to do is it's a lead source that allows you to have more prospects, more conversations, which leads to more sales, where we provide landlines, cell phones, and emails that you can make things actionable. But I just want to jump into a few case studies right away, Becca, and just kind of tell you guys on how other small businesses are having success. And everything I'm going to talk about are things that you can actually do with your own sphere today, right? So even if you don't buy our product, obviously I love our product, we've been here for 15 years, so I'm going to recommend everybody to use it. But even if it's not what you want, and you all have your own sphere and your own database, these are things that you should be doing today as well. So the first case study I want to talk to everybody about is how to become a community dominator. And this is a real estate agent who's the number one realtor in South Carolina. And for all of you guys, if you're not familiar with the real estate term of farming a neighborhood, have you heard of that before, Becca, how to farm a neighborhood?
I understand the concept. It's basically right. Like you get in there, and it's what I teach with door knocking. I have a lesson called Dominating Your Neighborhood, and it's about you become a fixture there, and everybody just, you harvest the whole neighborhood because you're constantly there. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. So the term farm is very, what everybody in the real estate term world knows. And so I interviewed Greg here recently because, you know, a number one realtor in South Carolina, he's been a client of ours for a decade. And I asked him, well, how do you dominate your farms, Greg? And he says one of the first things that he does is he wants to pick the farm that he wants to go after. So, you know, in his case, it could be a neighborhood that he has access to, that maybe it's, that he lives in, that his kids go to school in, right? That he goes, a neighborhood that's by the church that he belongs to.
Right.
You know, or maybe, and a lot of people on this call, maybe it's a neighborhood that you know was built about 20 years ago, and now is when people are going to start needing to do improvements on their house, right? Maybe that's your farm.
Storm hit there or whatever.
Exactly. And then he talked about holding some sort of community event and inviting the neighbors to participate. And I just think that's a great way for everybody here, a non-intrusive way to get to know the neighborhood. So he would talk about me having a movie in the park and then calling and emailing all the neighbors to the movie in the park. Now with COVID-19, I'm not sure if that's available, but we should be doing that. However, think outside the box. You know, a lot of clients in all industries right now, they're teaming up with food shelters or blood banks or just nonprofits in general. And they're calling and emailing the neighborhood and saying, hey, we have the local blood bank is really short right now. Have you thought about donating blood? There's a blood mobile set up, you know, across from your neighborhood at 70th and Old Cheney. Next Tuesday at 7 p.m. I'd love for you to donate blood. And you brand it that I am the local, you know, home services professional. I'm at 70th and Old Cheney. We're in this together, right? And then brand it that you're the local industry expert. And then, hey, if you have, and then you can just start asking questions to people, right? So you call, you email, and then you talk to people. You can say, hey, you know, how long have you lived in the neighborhood? What do you like about the neighborhood? What do you like about your house? Is there anything that you don't like about your house? And you start having conversations with people. I know of a lot of people who are maybe having a food truck come to a neighborhood. So they'll contact a local, you know, Mexican food truck, have them stop by. There we go, the taco truck, exactly. Having them go to at the Edenton South Subdivision Park and now calling and emailing all the neighbors, support local. Here's a local food truck that you should be supporting. And then just building that brand awareness and meeting people, having conversations with people.
Yeah.
Okay. And then, or if it's not, maybe it's not a neighborhood that you want to dominate, but you just did a job site. You just did a job within a specific neighborhood. Now is the time to leverage that job. So right. You could contact with Cole. You could go in and do a radius. You can map out the neighborhood, or maybe just grab the closest 15 neighbors. Maybe if you're, okay, that's great, Tyler, but I'll never call or email 500 people. Well, could you do 15, right? And then go into our product, grab the immediate neighbors up and down that street and leverage that job site as a way to reach out to the neighbors.
And Tyler, is there a way to extract, let's say that you do choose a radius, right? Mm-hmm. Yep. Is there a way to extract maybe a CSV or is a CVS?
Oh, yep.
Okay, so you could maybe extract a certain group of people in a location and import that into a CRM and do an email blast if you have something like that.
Absolutely. So within our product, and I'll show you here in a sec, guys, but you can map out or you can do a radius. Let's say your list is 400 addresses that come up with cell phones and emails, all the contact information. There's a download button. You just pick Excel or .csv, download it to within 30 seconds, your files in the format of your choice, and then you can upload it into any system that you're using. Right. The biggest thing for us, Becca, is the multi-channel approach at a very hyper-local area. So we talk about you call the people that you can call, you email the people that you can email, you door knock the people that you can door knock. And then the last piece that people will do is they'll upload that same list into Facebook for a custom audience. And we have some tutorial videos on how to do that, but it goes back to Lincoln, Nebraska, population 300,000. I don't wanna do a Facebook ad for all of Lincoln, but I might want to do it for just the 800 people in Edenton South subdivision.
Right.
And if you're doing that on top of all these other layers, what Greg will say is that that's how you become a community dominator.
Well, and I love this because if you're really good at marketing, you understand the multi-touch approach is the most mm-hmm. effective. Like people need to see your thing 3, 4, 5, 6 times sometimes before they actually do something. So when we think about, like, let's say that there's a build going on in the neighborhood, if you extract the leads from that neighborhood, right, or the surrounding couple miles or whatever, and you send out an email first, it's like, hey, just heads up, we're doing your neighbor XYZ's house at this location on this day. You know, let us know if you have any questions or pardon us for the noise, you know, that whole chestnut where we talk about, like, if any trash blows into your yard, blah, blah, blah. And then send up a follow-up email. Hey, by the way, we had just let you know we're doing this roof on Saturday. The reason we're doing the Johnson's roof is because that storm you guys had in your neighborhood on April 2nd actually caused quite a bit of damage. You send a couple photos, but if you haven't had anybody check, let us know. You know, their insurance company paid for the whole thing. Now you're sending that you've got follow-ups, you have photos, and then you go and door knock on top of it. That's how you really, really warm up the whole neighborhood.
Yes, absolutely. And with those emails, you know, again, we're not telling you to email all of Lincoln, Nebraska. That doesn't get you any good, right? We're saying, hey, how about
focused?
Exactly. The 300 emails in Edenton South, and then the subject line, mention Edenton South subdivision in the subject line, or mention 505 Apple Street in the subject line, because then you get really high open rates, right? And then you, because it's relevant to them. It means something for them, right? And then in the neighbor that you want to farm, per se, then you could be creating an e-newsletter specific for that neighborhood. It could be the Edenton South e-newsletter, and you're always just providing them content, you know, helpful hints on how to keep up with their home and home values and just things like that that are relevant for that neighborhood, right? To just keep top of mind for all those people that you want to keep in touch with. Absolutely. So yeah, and you know, I have tons of case studies, so I don't need to go over like, hey, here's a zillion of them, but here's a roofer in Fort Worth that just gets it, right, Becca? So they've been a client of ours for 6 or 7 years now, and they recently gave us this testimonial, but they basically said there's really no better way to break into a community than with phone calls, letters, emails, etc. So it combines all those things that we're talking about.
Right.
And they said that we have closed 100 jobs, $1.5 million in 2019 by using Cole, right? By just making the data actionable, having conversations with people, right?
Yeah. So
again, just additional ways. And then leveraging technology to help make it happen. So guys, again, you can send emails. There's lots of different systems out there to send emails. You can make a ton of phone calls with this little guy, an iPhone, right? So if you lock yourself in a room, you can make 100 phone calls in 2 hours. Right. And just having conversations with people. And that's super easy to do. But there's other systems out there, and you know, ringless voicemails are pretty popular right now. And are you familiar with the term ringless voicemail? I'm assuming, right, Becca?
Yeah, everybody's probably had that experience. All right. Of a sudden, it says you have a voicemail, and you're like, it didn't ring. It's
exactly.
Like sending messages without actually having to make the phone ring.
Exactly. So if you guys aren't familiar with the term ringless voicemail, essentially means is that you can, there's systems out there that where you can actually you can put in a cell phone number, record a voicemail, hit send, and the cell phone never rings, and it just delivers the voicemail to somebody. So a lot of people like to use it if you want to like update a client with what's going on, but you don't want to talk to them for 20 minutes, just to right. Leave them a voicemail. But they also have technology where you can upload 50 cell phone numbers or 500 cell phone numbers all at once. So what a lot of people will do is they'll go into Cole, grab 500 cell phone numbers for that neighborhood. Again, not all of Lincoln, Nebraska, the 500 people, and they'll leave a voicemail that's compelling and descriptive in response to that neighborhood. So it could be referencing a job site, like we had talked about earlier. Hey, you know, sorry if we're on Saturday, if you hear some loud noise, we're going to be working on the Jones's roof at 505 Apple Street, yada, yada, yada. Or it's going back and right now with COVID-19, you know, talking about a nonprofit that you're working with. Hey, we're going to be collecting food for the People's City Mission. We'll be at the neighborhood park on Saturday from noon to 2. We'd love for you to stop by, drop off canned food, and we're going to donate it on behalf of the Edenton South neighborhood, right?
Right. And you get a chance to connect and talk to people and let them, hey, by the way, this is why we're out here right now. You know?
Exactly. Just having conversations with people. So yeah, just keep that in mind. There's lots of ringless voicemail systems out there. This client of ours, you know, he basically used it a while back and got a $15,000 commission in 15 minutes. By doing just that, he sent emails to the, you know, the 300 emails that he had out of a subdivision, got the 500 cell phones, uploaded them to Slide. He uses SlideDial. There's lots of other systems out there, but SlideDial is one of the partners that we refer people to, SlyDial.com. And then he used a quick hint here, guys. He used a Google phone number. So you can get a Google phone number. It's a local phone number for free, maybe $10 a month, depending on how much you want to use it. So when he dropped that voicemail, he left his phone number that was a Google phone number that was just for that campaign. So as people called him back, he knew it was instantly in reference to that campaign that he had done. And he wasn't like stumbling around trying to figure who was calling him back. Right. Just another way to use technology. And then the last key, I already talked about it with Greg Harrelson earlier, is in taking that same list, uploading it into Facebook for a custom audience. And that's what we teach folks to do as well. So yeah. you're sort of omnipresent at that point, right? And here's a contractor in Cincinnati that gets it. And you know, they basically say to take it one step further, we can now get in contact with more prospects by executing a multi-channel approach using the homeowner landlines, cell phones, and email addresses. Our brand recognition has increased exponentially from our ability to grab target zip codes and implement email campaigns with relevant content for homeowners. And that's sort of marketing 101, right? Is that what you would say? I mean, what's your thoughts on that?
Well, so what we're talking about here is the more information you have about the leads that you're going after, the more opportunities you have to reach them. So if you have their landline, their phone number, their email address, their name, right. These are things that most people like, think about when you go and knock a door, you're going in totally blind.
Right.
I have no idea, right? And I think again, it's how creative are you willing to get? Because the more exposure that you can get using these multi-step approaches, whether it's creating an event, doing an email blast, sending out ringless voicemails or whatever it is, the more exposure, like the more you've got going on, the more you can attract back to your company. And I definitely want to talk a little bit more. I know a lot of people are always asking about commercial leads. And so one of the big questions that people always have for me is how do you get to the gatekeeper? And this is the answer to that. Like think about cold neighborhood information, like your big fat phone book that has all the intel in it for reaching these people. So if there's a commercial property that you're after, you want to find out more information about it, you can use this system to locate the owner, their cell phone number, their email address, So if you want to talk a little bit about that, because I know that's a huge thing that people, when they're trying to go after commercial stuff, that they're always asking about. So Tyler, if you have anything to add about using the system for that, I'd love to hear it.
Yeah, no, and we'll get, when I hop into the product here in a little bit, I'll show everybody on the commercial side of things as well. Commercial is its own different animal, right? It's definitely harder than residential data as well. But one of the things with Cole is you can go in, you can grab and do a certain search by a genre, you know, if there's a certain industry you want to go after, or just you want to network with all the businesses, you know, if you want to find all the businesses in zip code 68516, right? And boom, here they all, here's their contact information. So you can go out there and just reach out to all those people. And then you do a little research and figure out who actually owns the property. You can look them up one by one in our system, try to find their cell phones, their emails, things like that as well. So I'll jump into that when we're talking about that here in a bit as well. So great question. So the last thing I want to talk about, everybody, is a concept of micro-marketing. And if you haven't heard of the concept of micro-marketing before, it essentially means is who's your ideal prospect and how do you plan on going after them, right? So if you've heard of the phrase of the jack of all trades, but a master of none. So essentially what you could do, you know, using Cole is going in and put in a couple of zip codes, apply desired filters like confirmed homeowners, a credit score of 650 or higher, an income level of 100K or more, a year built of 10 years or more, and then output that list and utilize the provided cell phones and emails to fill the pipeline. For some of you guys that maybe you have your own like sphere, I would say you always want to be networking with, you know, people that you go to church with, people that you maybe go to a Rotary Club with or a VFW with, maybe you're part of a golf league, right? Or you work out at a workout facility. Those are also people that could be micro-marketing, just people that you want to like network with more as network with as well. But Cole then, you know, allows you to go in, and this will jump in, use all these different filters. So instead of going after, you know, 300,000 people in Lincoln, then it's going after maybe 300 people to really put your focus in, or 3,000 people on top of those farms. So I'm just going to jump in real quickly, if you don't mind, give a quick little, you know, 3 or 4 minute video or overview of the different systems that are included as well. So if you guys signed up, you'd get access to your entire state. And if you're on, if you're multiple states, if you need to as well. So meaning if you're in, let's say Kansas City, you'd get access to both Missouri and Kansas, right? We have lots of tutorial videos. So, you know, you'd watch, you know, different videos like on how to use our data with social. We'd include, you know, just watch lots of case studies. We do lots of interviews with clients. We always try to, you know, make sure to have success using our system. But I'm going to go in and say, hey, I want a list of everybody who in this zip code. So I'm going to put a zip code search and I narrow it down by everybody who owns their home. And let's say has a credit rating of at least 650 or higher, and an income level of maybe 100,000 or more. Again, just so we can kind of bring up a list to kind of show everybody. We can narrow it down by interest. Maybe if you're, you know, wanted to sponsor a golf outing, you could find golfers in your area. Maybe you want to go after high-end owners, so you want to find high-end vehicles that they drive. You know, just random things like that. Race, language. Obviously, the more criteria you put in your list, the smaller it is. And for this list, I'm going to say, hey, I want everybody to have at least one email address. And honestly,
by the way, I want to just insert something here. People are always asking too, how do we get into these gated neighborhoods? And if you want to target finding the homeowners' names using Cole Neighborhood by looking up value of the property, average income, stuff like that, now you can actually get into the neighborhood by, you might have to make a few phone calls to get somebody to say yes to your appointment, just like any other way, whether you're door knocking or not. Once you get into that neighborhood, now you're in. And now all these $1 million houses that have 50, 60 square roofs on them that you're staring at from behind the gated entrance, you know, before, you have an in here. So you get one person to say yes, and now you can name drop the shit out of that and get referrals and all of that. So this is a really powerful tool. You know,
yes, name dropping is huge, right? Even if, you know, referencing other neighbors when you're talking to people, I mean, that's what's huge. So yeah, here, this list had 4,300 records that displayed. So again, remember we did it by credit range. I made email mandatory for this list, and then a higher income level. But you can see here, I also have added the age of each person. So now right away, I know how old the person is that I'm talking to. And then I also added year built, so I could reference that during my campaign. So maybe I wanted to then download this list. Again, you just take it right to Excel or pick CSV file and download. So super easy to take that file and download it. But that way you include all these fields when you download it, and you might do a filter and sort it. And anybody who's above a certain age, because they might be retiring, need to fix up their house before they move to a retirement home, they might get a different email campaign from you. Anybody with a certain year built, an older house versus a newer house. Again, that's how you take data and filter it to help with higher response rates, right, as well. So that's just how to do a zip code search. And I could, all the different searches you could do here. But the other one I want to show would be the neighborhood search. So I could say, hey, I want everybody in that neighborhood, a specific neighborhood. It's going to ask you for a starting point address or at least a street within that neighborhood that you're familiar with. So I'm going to use a house, a neighborhood in that I'm familiar with that is about 30 to 40 years old. I think it has, a little bit more money in this in Lincoln as well. So it's going to ask for a starting point address. I'm going to put that in here and hit search. It's going to tell me who is tied to the property. So the people that are tied to that property and their contact information. So for here, we have emails, but I'm not, if you want to look up individual addresses. So again, this would be good if you're just driving through a neighborhood and you see a house that needs repairs.
Yeah.
To look up those addresses one by one, get their cell phones and emails where available. And then I can map it out here. So this gives me a bird's eye view of Edenton South. So I'm just going to go here on this side of the school, this side of the Berean Church, this side of Sheridan Lutheran Church. This is Edenton South, everybody. I'm familiar with it. And view your available prospects. So your list guys could bring up, 50 people or 5,000 people, right? Depending on how big of an area that I'm prospecting. I did narrow it down by confirmed homeowners only. And we had 900 people within that neighborhood. So you can see here, we get a combination of their names, contact names above 18 in the household. We have landlines were available, cell phones were available, and then email addresses were available. We don't have it for everybody, but you combine that and we have some sort of contact information for a good majority of all homeowners. So,
well, and I'm even thinking too, like I have all these ideas about how you can use this to send out emails, but think about you get a copy of a hail swath, right? You zoom in on it, you map out on there the neighborhood that these people live in on the swath, which shows the bright red area where there was, 2-inch hail or whatever. You send a series of emails that say, hey, this is where you live. We've done inspections in this area where the storm hit. You can see on the map, you'll right smack dab in the middle of it. And then you send a follow-up email. Hey, we've done inspections for the Smiths, the Johnsons, the Greens. Here are some photos of the damage on their roof. If you haven't had a free inspection, call me today. And then you can do a follow-up phone call. So this is just, it's giving you so much power to be able to reach people specifically and personally and give them information that otherwise you might not be able to give to them.
Exactly. Exactly. Yep. And then if you want to farm and own the neighborhood, everybody, I always say you need to call everybody, email everybody, invite everybody to a community event because they know somebody who might give you a referral down the way as well, right? Because you built that rapport. Maybe they don't need your services now, but they might know somebody in the future that will. And then you can see I added some additional fields again to this list. So I added the age of the person. I added the length of residence because maybe someone just moved in. They're not ready to do updates yet, right? So maybe you only want to focus on people who've been there for 5 years, 10 years. And then here I added the year built to the house as well. So again, you guys know the neighborhoods that are ideal for you to prospect in based off the year built or, the turnover, what's going on here. So you can hear a lot of these were built in the mid 1980s, right? So now they're second owners coming in, might want to be doing updates, things like that as well.
Yeah.
So just taking data. And then to kind of talk about the commercial side, I don't want to mislead everybody. We don't have, it's not the most in-depth commercial data, but yeah, you could do a search by SIC code, which is basically a business type. So if I wanted to find, if you wanted to network with certain businesses, a lot of people want to network with real estate agents, right? Because they want the referrals when the repairs need done. You could go in here and do a search for all of the real estate agents in your area or your zip code. And then do a search. You could do that. Or you could just say, hey, I want every business in a zip code. because you want to do a networking campaign just with every business in the zip code. So different things you can do that there as well.
And can you pick, let's say that you pick a business and you just look up the address. Can you find like ownership there?
So you don't, and that's where I don't want to mislead you, Becca. And again, we didn't do a lot of practice ahead of this time either. So on the commercial side, it's a lot tougher. So we are not going to have who owns the property. It's going to be who lives at the property, or sorry, who's leasing the property. But usually you can make that phone call and then make that connection pretty easily, right? Of who actually owns
as opposed to going and knocking on the business door and just sitting there and she's like, I make $11 an hour.
Like, exactly.
Okay, I understood then how that worked exactly, but still a very powerful, useful tool. You can get into contact with somebody that's affiliated with it and not have
exactly
to talk to the receptionist at the
exactly
desk.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So that's it. And then guys, it's unlimited. So the biggest thing with our product that I think the biggest advantage is we don't charge by the record, by the name, by the download. It's a 1-year subscription and you can get as many downloads as you want to for the year. And per small business, it's normally $9.95 for the year. So what does that come out to? About 80 some bucks a month or whatever.
It's not even one roof.
Right? Not even, right? And then for you, Becca, so I have your landing page here. So everybody go to the landing page that's shown on the screen. So partner.coleinformation.com/roofsalesmastery. And we are knocking an additional $200 off. I don't know how long we'll do this, but as part of the new partnership with you, Becca, we're promoting that. We love the referrals you're sending our way. So it's an additional $200 off. Make sure you mention Becca's name or even just call our inside sales team. I'm on Zooms like this all day long, every day, but we have a dedicated sales team. They're familiar with this partnership with Becca. So just call the 800 number on the screen as well, 800-800-3271, and ask for more details. They can give you a demo of your area if you want to as well and answer other questions you might have. We do, I'm guessing we have some large customers on here who have multiple states or have crews across the country. We have different plans on that as well. So then $795 is more for, a small business who's doing their own thing, but we'd love to work with you. We have lots of plans out there as well.
Well, and again, the way that I look at it, like in our business, the revenue opportunity is so massive. When you look at what one roof puts $1,500 in the business owner's pocket, even when they're splitting a commission with a salesperson. So it's like invest half of a roof to have a giant database where you're going to be able to create hundreds of prospects every single year that you otherwise couldn't get. So I mean, I think it's just a no-brainer. I think that this is just a great tool, especially right now, for people to get really creative and be able to get into contact with people that they otherwise wouldn't be able to reach. And again, it's the multi-touch, and you guys can look into this more on your own and study it, but the multi-step approach where you have, oh, there's an ad, and then they get a voicemail, and then they get a text message, and then they get an email, and then they get my door hanger, and then they meet me in person, or they see me doing it. It's like, now you're everywhere. You're omnipresent.
You used it. I love it. That's some omnipresent. Yes. That's exactly right? What it is. Yes. And what Greg Harrelson, so going back to my first case study, the mega realtor in South Carolina, he talks about is, people then don't realize that they think that he's doing this for all of Lincoln, Nebraska, right? They think that he's like, that Greg is everywhere. Man, everybody in Lincoln must know him. Wow. But in reality, guys, he's just doing it for the 800 people in that subdivision, right? Yeah. And now he's at the point where he does it for multiple subdivisions. And so, it's really honing in on that. And then doubling down and leveraging, and I call it exploiting, any current customers you have, any new job site. So in the real estate world,
definitely.
I just like to use these examples, but in the real estate world, a lot of agents do this with an open house, right? They do an open house on Sunday from noon to 2:00. And they do it for the reason, not to even just sell that house specifically, but as a reason to reach out to the neighbors. It gives them a reason to contact the neighbors. So just like you guys, if you have a job site coming up and you're sending a crew out there, it gives you a reason, a non-confrontational reason, an informational reason to do an outreach.
And I love that. And I want to expand upon it because something that I always talk about when I'm talking about door knocking is treating it more like a PSA. Like, instead of going and feeling like you're selling something, you approach it like you're there to bring them relevant information that's relevant to them because of the circumstance, where they live, what happened, the age of their house, what their neighbor's doing, whatever it is. So if you use a system like Cole Information, you get a list of people in this very, you know, hyper-focused micro-marketing area, right? So you pick this area and you send out an email. It's like, hey, my name's Tyler, and I'm just giving you a heads up. We're doing your neighbor, you know, the Johnson's roof. They're right there on the corner in the blue house. Here's a hail swap. The reason we're doing the roof is because there's actually quite a bit of damage. Here's a few pictures. You know, if you have any questions, or let us know, the noise shouldn't last more than a day or two. Yeah. And then you send another email. Here's the brand new roof. The cool thing about it is insurance paid for it. So the Johnson's got this 98% off, which is pretty sweet, right? You know? And then you send another email. Hey, we've had such a great response from how great the roof looks, and people wanted to make sure that their roof was okay. You know, I'm doing free inspections for the neighbors this day, and this day. And then you can call them and say, hey, we've been sending you a couple emails, let you know what's up. I can come over and do an inspection for you on Thursday at 4. Would 6:30 work better?
Yep.
So, but that's like, that is some sniper shit.
Yeah.
That you're using, doing it that way. But you can't do that otherwise. What do you do? Go hand write a note on it.
Right. Right.
Draw a picture of the hail. So, like, you know, so I think.
No, you're exactly. And everything you just said there, I love too, because it wasn't salesy. Everything that you just did was more like informative, right?
PSA. It's helpful.
Yeah. Exactly. I mean, there's nothing salesy involved with that. And that's how you can let people let their guard down a little bit then when you're doing things like that, and they'll be more receptive to having conversations with people. And that's what you're doing. You're having conversations.
Yeah.
Right. So guys.
Yeah. I was just going to say, especially when you're doing the PSA approach, we call it jab, 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 punch in marketing, right? Which is value, 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 offer. So give them some value, some information, give them some more value, give them one more thing of value, call them up.
Yep.
Give them text messages this time or this time, make an offer, ask for two times, boom. And now, you know how it goes. Now you've got this person, and now your list is even bigger because you sent out an email and you're like, we've done this house and this house, and we're doing inspection on this house and this house. So it's just the snowball effect that you can leverage enormously doing it this way. So I hope people see the value in that, and they grasp onto it, because it's going to be cool when you start using it.
I agree 100%. So we are at like 40 minutes now. I'm ready. I think we call it good. So if you guys, I know there's a few questions in the question box. Just please call our inside sales team, get more information. They'll be glad to answer any questions you have. That's for sure. We would love to support you in this endeavor. We think it's a great way for you to grow your business, think outside the box, and really achieve the goals that you have for the year. Beck, any last minute advice or anything that you think that maybe I missed?
I don't think so. We posted the link here in the chat box so you can get that discount. So you guys can just click and follow that link. I will send up a follow-up email as well that just has like the replay. If you want to catch anything else, look back at it. And then the link so that you can get signed up. But I don't think so, unless anybody else has pressing questions here. Which I don't really see. So
cool. Good. So I'm going to leave it off here. So Becca, thank you for allowing me to present to your audience. It was a pleasure. That's for sure. My last minute words and advice is take action. So I would love if you consider Cole, but even if you don't consider Cole, go do something. Go make it happen, guys. So even if you locked yourself in a room tomorrow for 2 hours and called every hot lead that you've gotten over the last 2 years that you haven't had a chance to close yet, or you call everybody in your database and ask for referrals, anything like that, go do it and see what happens. And I haven't heard of somebody who said, yeah, I wasted 2 hours making phone calls and never got anything out of it. Like, it just means that you got to do it. And then once you see success, think, how can I 10 times that? How can I put that on steroids? How can I take it to the next level?
Yeah.
And then see what might happen. So, but take action. Okay.
Yeah. And one other thing, this is a little bit on a tangent, but I just was thinking, like, you know how quickly you can make 10 phone calls? Like, compared to door knocking, think about, like, if you can send out text messages, if you just set aside 15 or 20 minutes a day to make some calls or throw out some texts or something like that, or when it's pouring down rain and you're like, well, I guess I can't work today.
Exactly.
You can sit there and make 15 phone calls. Like, when I sold Cutco Knives, I was just constantly on the phone. Like, you know, And it works. You add this to your arsenal, like the best people at this craft or at sales are just, they're just getting in the mix in as many ways as possible. And so add this into your mix.
Love it. Let's end with that. All right, Becca, appreciate it, guys.
Tyler, it's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for your time. And we'll catch you guys later.
Bye.
Bye.